The last topic in colloids, its applications. Let's see different applications of colloids. First one, electrical precipitation of smoke. Smoke, when it comes out from chimney in an industry, when smoke comes out of chimney, it is just passed into a chamber where an electrode with opposite charges is present. So when the smoke comes into contact with that electrode, which is having opposite charge, they get coagulated. Smoke is nothing but in smoke, what are the particles that are present? Some arsenous compounds, carbon particles, some other particles are present in smoke. Okay, now these particles, if they are released into the atmosphere directly, what happens? They cause air pollution. That's why before it is released into atmosphere, the dust particles must be removed from the gases. The industrial smoke contains some gases also. So if these suspended particles are removed, at least some pollution can be prevented in the atmosphere. So for that, there is a Cottrell's precipitator. There is an apparatus, Cottrell's precipitator. This Cottrell's precipitator contains an electrode with opposite charge. This is an electrode with opposite charge. This is exit for gases, this is inlet for smoke. It is inlet for smoke. These all smoke particles, when coming to contact with this electrode with around 30,000 volts potential. This is called Cottrell's precipitator. Cottrell's precipitator. So smoke must be passed into this chamber, Cottrell's precipitator. If the smoke is released as it is from the chimney, what happens? Along with the dust particles, it enters into atmosphere and it pollutes that atmosphere. That's why before releasing into the atmosphere through chimney, it is first sent into a chamber where oppositely charged electrode or plates are present. When smoke come into contact with this electrode or plates, the dust particles present in the dust, smoke particles present in the smoke gets coagulated. Those coagulated particles all. So first application, electrical precipitation of smoke. Smoke contains carbon particles, some arsenic impurities, and some other solid particles. These particles are released directly into the atmosphere from an industry. These particles causes air pollution. That's why before released into the atmosphere, this smoke must be coagulated. So for that, the smoke is first sent into a chamber containing oppositely charged electrodes. Okay, so here the chamber is named as Cottrell's precipitator. It is an important important apparatus used for the coagulation of smoke. This Cottrell's precipitator contains an electrode at a high potential with opposite charge. When the smoke enters into this chamber, the solid particles in that smoke, the colloidal particles, get coagulated and they form a dust in the floor of the chamber. So all the solid particles settle down as dust. This is the dust or smoke settled down. Not smoke, it is dust or soot. Soot settled down in the floor of a chamber. Now the gases, without these suspended particles, gases without suspended particles, released out. So now this these gases now do not contain any suspended particles. So in that way, all the dust particles are removed using these apparatus. So in that way, electrical precipitation of smoke using the Cottrell's operator precipitator, we can coagulate the smoke which is released from an industry. See the second one, purification of drinking water. Purification of drinking water. You know, drinking water, generally water from different sources, river water, canal water, lake water, they contain some suspended clay particles. They are in colloidal range. So that water is not fit for drinking because some suspended clay particles there are. Because by normal filtration, they cannot be separated. I said earlier that normal filtration cannot separate dispersed phase from the dispersion media. That's why to this some alum is added. Alum means it's a double salt. What is the formula of alum? What are the two salts present in alum? Hydrated double salt it is. Potassium salt and aluminium salt. These two are present in alum. You know, these salts give some cations and anions. Those ions coagulate the clay particles that are suspended in the water collected from different sources. So because of this, this coagulation by alum, the suspended clay particles simply settled down. Now we can filter it. Now the clay particles can be separated easily from the water. Now this water we can use for drinking purpose. So in that way, in the purification of drinking water, which substance is added? Yes, alum is used. For electrical precipitation of smoke, which apparatus is used? Cottrell's precipitator. Similarly, for purification of drinking water, alum is used. Also called common alum, potassium, aluminium sulfates. If present, that is called common alum. Third one, medicines. You know, some medicines are taken in the form of colloidal solution as emulsions or as salts, etc. So among them, some examples are silver salt. You know, silver salt used in eye drops. Antimony salt. This antimony salt is used in curing the disease. Kalazar. It is a chronic disease which is due to enlargement of spleen. Very chronic disease it is. For the curing of this disease, Kalazar, colloidal antimony is used. Antimony salt. Similarly, gold salt is used as intramuscular injection. It is used as intramuscular injection. Similarly, magnesium hydroxide salt, also called milk of magnesia. This magnesium hydroxide salt is called what? Milk of magnesia. Milk of magnesia. It is used for stomach disorders. Stomach disorders. So these are some medicines which are in colloidal range. Why colloidal solutions are more effective? Because these are having more surface area. I said in the beginning, colloidal particles are having more surface area. Because of that, these colloidal solutions can be assimilated easily into the body. Because of easy assimilation, the disease can be cured easily. So in that way, medicines, most of the medicines we use for different diseases, for the treatment of different diseases, are colloidal solutions. So this is third one. Next, fourth one. Tanning of leather. Or leather tanning. What is leather tanning? You know, animal skin is also a colloidal solution. Animal skin is also a colloidal solution. You know, it's a positive colloid. Animal skin is a positive colloid. When it is soaked in a chemical, tannin, tannin is a chemical. When it is soaked in tannin, the skin becomes hard. This type of hardening of animal skin by soaking in tannin is called tanning of leather. The hardened skin is called leather. What is leather? Hardened skin. Generally, skin is soft. The soft skin is hardened by soaking this skin into some chemical called tannin. That process is called leather tanning. You know, leather, this leather is used for making chappals, shoes, belts, etc. So, leather is nothing but hardened skin. Skin is a positive colloid. Where tannin is a negative colloid. Tannin is a negative colloid. When skin is soaked in tannin, what happens? There occurs mutual coagulation. Because of mutual coagulation, the particles in skin, they aggregate and becomes hard. Okay, generally chromium salts are used in place of tanning. Chromium salts are used in place of tanning. Fifth one, working of cleansing action of soaps and detergents. Cleansing action of soaps and detergents. Already I have discussed the cleansing action of soap in types of colloids. So here, what happens when soap is dissolved in water? There occurs a micelle formation. When the concentration of soap exceeds some value, that means critical micelle concentration. When the concentration of solution reaches critical micelle concentration, soap molecules are pulled and aggregation occurs. That aggregated soap molecules is called aggregation of soap molecules is called micelle. So these micelles dissolve grease or oil at their interior part, and in that way the grease or oil is separated from the dirty surface by the muscles. So in that way a dirty surface is cleaned. So here also cleansing action of soap or detergents is due to formation of a colloid, that means formation of an emulsion. So soap or detergent emulsifies water and the oil or fat that on the dirty surface. Sixth one, rubber is obtained from latex, a milky suspension excreted by rubber plants is called latex. This latex, you know, it's a negative colloid. Latex is a negative colloid. This latex is hydrosol. Why? There rubber particles, solid rubber particles, DP, water is dispersion medium. So latex is solid in liquid type colloidal solution, and of course it's a negative colloidal solution. When this latex is coagulated by the addition of salts, rubber is formed. So what is the difference between latex and rubber? Latex is a colloidal solution where rubber is coagulated colloidal solution. So this natural rubber has so many uses. You know that I will discuss uses of natural rubber in a separate chapter, polymers. There I will discuss. Okay, so rubber is obtained by the coagulation of latex, which is a negative colloid, which is a solid in liquid type colloidal solution. Last, some industrial products. So many industrial products which we use in daily life are colloids. See, paints, lubricants, cement. Okay, so these are all some examples for colloidal solutions. Okay, these are applications of colloids. So the chapter surface chemistry is completed. In surface chemistry there are three parts: adsorption, catalysis, colloids. Okay.